Hi everyone, and welcome back to our channel. In today's video, we're going to take a look at the project costing Odoo module developed by Openinside. Project cost management is the process by which one plans and manages the budget of a business or project. In the case of a project, it helps the project manager estimate what the project will cost and set in place controls by which they can reduce the chance of the project going over budget. At the close of the project, the actual costs that have been collected and documented are then compared to the estimated costs determined at the beginning of the project. This actual versus plan comparison is valuable data for predicting future project costs. Let's get started with our demo. The project costing module is based on analytic accounts, and entries in the module are pulled from the cost and revenue page of the analytic accounts. First of all, we need to have a product. A finished product. The product that you'd like to sell and would like to know how much it costs your company. Go to the inventory module to create a new product. Product name. Stage. Product type, service. Service tracking should create a project without task. Secondly, we need to create four product categories: manpower, equipment, subcontractors, and material. Go to the project module. Then to costing category configuration. Select all. And press the actions button to create product categories. The third step is to create the required products in the inventory with the following attributes. We will create a material product, which is the physical or tangible product that will be consumed in the project. For example, we need a carpet to cover the floor. We will create a new product. Product name, carpet. We use this checkboxes to specify if the product is storable or can be purchased. Then select the product category, materials category. Ensure to activate the automatic accounting option in the accounting settings, and the inventory valuation in the materials category is automated. Now we have to create manpower product. This will be the product assigned to an employee's timesheet. It's used to calculate the actual hours worked. Let's create this product now. Product name, labor charges. Product type, service. Product category, manpower category. You can leave the sales price and cost set to zero. Set the unit of measure to hours. Link this product with the employee timesheet by going to the employee module and assigning the created manpower product to the employee's timesheet product. In this example, we will assign it to Adam. Under HR settings, we will select the timesheet product, labor charge. And we will set an hourly cost. Now we will create equipment product. Equipment are products you plan to lease from a vendor and sublease to your customers. These products are not yours and will not have inventory stock. Product name, crane 60 tons. Product type, service. Product category, equipment. Now we will create a subcontractor's product, a product that you will buy from another vendor for your project. Product name, interior decoration. Product type, service. Product category, subcontractor category. The service type should be can be purchased. Now that we're done with creating our products, it's time to move to step number 4 and create the sales order for the wedding stage. We'll create a sales order. Select the customer. Add the master product that we intend to sell, which is the stage. Enter the unit price. The system will auto-create an analytic account for this order. This analytic account will be used to link all entities together, as the costing module relies on the project's analytic account entries. Step 5 is to set up our forecast. A smart button, costing, is now showing at the top of sales order page. This is where all the work is done. It's divided into four sections. We must fill in our planned amounts and quantities for each component. The last step is to see the actual costs incurred from this sales order. Let's go through it one by one. Manpower costing. Actual values for manpower are pulled from the timesheet of the employee, which is linked to a project, which is linked to the created analytic account of the sales order. Subcontractors costing. Actual values for subcontractors are pulled from vendor bills. Once a vendor bill linked to the sales order's analytic account is issued, actuals will be updated in the costing module. Materials costing. Actual values for material are pulled from delivery operations. Technically, this is an internal transfer from stock to a production location. Ensure you buy the needed material in the system and have an internal operation type with a default destination location. The default location type should be production. The stock valuation account, incoming, type should be set to expenses. Otherwise, it won't show on the gross margin page of the analytic account, from which the costing module pulls its data. Now, create an internal transfer for the material and ensure to add the analytic account in the transfer. Equipment costing. Actual values for equipment are created manually under the cost/revenue module inside the costing module. The manually entered line should be linked to the analytic account of the sales order. Go to Accounting, Configuration, Analytic Account, select the analytic account for the stage project. Values set in the gross margin must reflect the nature of the transaction. If it's a cost, the value should be negative. If it's revenue, it should be positive. Add the equipment product, which is the crane in this example. The amount should be the total amount of the line item and not the amount per unit. And there you have it. We have seen how we can set a planned or estimated budget for any given sales order, pull the actual numbers from the system, compare the forecasted and actuals, and get a good grasp of where your project is heading. You've reached the end of our tutorial on the project costing module developed by Openinside. Hopefully, this tutorial will put you on track and set the right direction using the module and getting the best out of it. If you enjoyed this video and want to explore more of Openinside's Odoo module tutorials, be sure to subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell to stay updated. Thank you, and see you in our next video.